Hey there, fellow traders. Welcome back to our channel Forex Titan FX. In today's video, we're diving into a topic that's often asked about, how to grow a small account in Forex trading. If you're new here, make sure to hit that subscribe button and the notification bell so you never miss our trading tips and insights. Let's jump right in. Segment 1, setting the foundation. Before we start, let's set the foundation right. Growing a small account in Forex trading requires patience, discipline, and a solid strategy. Remember, it's not a get-rich-quick scheme. It's about consistent progress over time. Later one, understand risk management. When it comes to risk management, determining the correct position size is paramount. The idea is to never risk more than a small portion of your trading capital on any single trade. This not only protects your account from significant losses, but also preserves your capital for future opportunities. The 1-2% rule. A common rule of thumb is the 1-2% rule. This means that for each trade, you should risk no more than 1-2% of your total trading capital. For example, if your account has $1,000, you should only risk $10-$20 per trade. This prevents a single trade from wiping out a substantial portion of your account. Use stop-loss orders effectively. Incorporating stop-loss orders is another crucial aspect of risk management. A stop-loss is a predetermined level at which your trade will automatically close to limit potential losses. Placing stop-losses. When placing a stop-loss, it's essential to consider the volatility of the currency pair you're trading. Placing a stop too close might result in premature closure due to minor price fluctuations, while placing it too far might expose your account to larger losses. A common approach is to place the stop loss just beyond a significant support or resistance level. Diversify your trades. Diversification is a principle that's not just for investing in stocks. It applies to Forex trading as well. Instead of putting all your eggs in one currency pair's basket, diversify your trades across different pairs. Avoid over-concentration. Over-concentration in a single currency pair exposes your account to higher risks, as adverse moves in that particular pair can have a more significant impact. Diversification spreads the risk and cushions your account against significant losses from a single trade. Avoid over-leveraging. Leverage can amplify both gains and losses. While it's enticing to use high leverage to potentially grow your account quickly, it also increases the risk of blowing up your account. Choose responsible leverage. Aim for conservative leverage levels, such as 10-to-1 or 20-to-1. This means for every dollar in your account, you control $10 or $20 in the market, respectively. Responsible leverage reduces the chance of a margin call and provides more room for your trades to breathe. Embrace the long game. Remember, Forex trading is not about making huge profits overnight. It's about consistent growth over time. By managing your risk diligently, you safeguard your account's longevity, allowing it to weather market fluctuations and eventually thrive. That wraps up our in-depth look at risk management in Forex trading. Implementing these strategies and principles will not only protect your account from devastating losses, but also position you for steady and sustainable account growth. Segment 2, selecting a strategy. Welcome back, traders. In this segment, we're going to delve into various trading strategies that you can use to grow your small Forex trading account. Remember, choosing the right strategy is essential for your success. Day trading strategy. Day trading involves making multiple trades within a single trading day. Traders aim to profit from short-term price movements. Scalping. Scalping is a form of day trading where traders make rapid-fire trades, holding positions for just a few seconds to a few minutes. They capitalize on small price movements, aiming for a high number of trades within a day. Breakout trading. Breakout traders identify key support and resistance levels and enter positions when the price breaks above resistance or below support. This strategy aims to catch significant price moves that often occur after periods of consolidation. Swing trading strategy. Swing trading involves holding positions for several days to weeks, capitalizing on medium-term price trends. Trend following. Trend following traders identify established trends and join the trend's direction. They enter trades in the direction of the prevailing trend, aiming to ride the trend until it shows signs of reversal. Fibonacci retracement. Swing traders who use Fibonacci retracement look for potential reversal levels after a significant price move. They identify key Fibonacci levels as potential entry points, anticipating a continuation of the trend after a retracement. Position trading strategy. Position trading involves holding positions for weeks, months, or even longer, targeting long-term trends. Fundamental analysis. Position traders often rely on fundamental analysis, considering factors like economic indicators, geopolitical events, and central bank policies. They make trades based on longer-term macroeconomic trends. Carry trade. The carry trade involves taking advantage of interest rate differentials between two currencies. A trader would go long on a currency with a higher interest rate and short on a currency with a lower interest rate, earning the interest rate differential as profit over time. Algorithmic trading strategy. Algorithmic trading, also known as algo trading or automated trading, involves using computer programs to execute trades based on predefined criteria. Moving average crossover. In this strategy, a trader uses two moving averages, one short-term and one long-term. When the short-term moving average crosses above the long-term moving average, it generates a buy signal, and vice versa for a sell signal. Mean reversion. Mean reversion strategies rely on the idea that prices will eventually revert to their historical mean. Algorithms identify overbought or oversold conditions and execute trades when prices move away from their average. And there you have it, traders, a comprehensive overview of various trading strategies you can employ to grow your small Forex trading account. Remember, no single strategy is superior. It's about finding what aligns with your trading style, risk tolerance, and schedule. Take the time to practice and backtest these strategies on a demo account before risking real capital. Once you've found your strategy, stick with it and refine your skills over time. If you found this segment helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe for more trading insights. Welcome back, traders. In this segment, we're going to dive into the crucial process of developing a trading plan. Having a well-defined trading plan is essential for growing your small Forex trading account. Segment 3, Technical and Fundamental Analysis. 1. Technical Analysis. Learn to read charts, identify trends, and use technical indicators. 1. These tools help you make informed decisions based on price movements. 1. I've made a complete video on technical analysis. 1. Link in the description. 1. Go and watch for details. 2. Fundamental analysis. Let's move on to fundamental analysis. 2. Keep an eye on economic indicators and news events that impact the Forex market. 2. Understanding the fundamentals can provide insights into potential market moves. Segment 4, Developing a Trading Plan. Welcome back, traders. In this segment, we're going to dive into the crucial process of developing a trading plan. Having a well-defined trading plan is essential for growing your small Forex trading account. Define your trading goals. The first step in developing a trading plan is to define your goals. What do you aim to achieve with your trading? Are you looking for consistent income, long-term growth, or a specific financial target? Having clear goals will guide your decision-making and keep you focused. Select your trading strategy. As we discussed earlier, selecting the right trading strategy is vital. Based on your goals, risk tolerance, and personal preferences, choose a strategy that aligns with your objectives. Entry and exit rules. Outline specific entry and exit rules for your trades. These rules should be based on your chosen strategy and technical or fundamental analysis. Clearly define when you will enter a trade, where you will place your stop loss, and when you will exit for profit or loss. Risk management guidelines. Incorporate risk management guidelines into your trading plan. Determine how much of your account capital you're willing to risk on each trade, usually 1-2%, and how you'll set your stop loss to adhere to this risk tolerance. Position sizing strategy. Decide how you'll determine your position sizes. Whether you use fixed lot sizes, a percentage of your account balance, or other methods, make sure it aligns with your risk management goals. Trading schedule. Outline your trading schedule. Are you a full-time trader or do you trade part-time? Determine the best times to trade based on your strategy and the currency pairs you're focusing on. Trading journal. Creating and maintaining a trading journal is crucial. Document each trade you take, including your reasons for entering, your emotions during the trade, and the outcome. This journal serves as a valuable tool for analyzing your strengths and weaknesses over time. Segment 5, Continuous Learning and Adaptation. A wise saying is that, learning is earning. Recognize that the Forex market evolves, and your trading plan should adapt accordingly. Stay updated. Keep learning and staying updated on market trends, new indicators, and trading psychology. Attend webinars, read books, and follow reputable sources of information.
Review and refine.
Regularly review your trading plan. Is it still aligned with your goals? Are there any aspects that need adjustment? Be open to refining your plan as you gain experience and encounter new market conditions.
Backtesting and demo trading.
Before implementing your trading plan with real money, backtest it using historical data to see how it would have performed. Then, practice on a demo account to ensure you can execute your plan effectively in real-time conditions.
Congratulations!
You've taken a big step towards success by developing a comprehensive trading plan. Remember, a trading plan is not set in stone. It's a dynamic document that evolves as you do. Stick to your plan, remain disciplined, and you'll be on your way to growing your small Forex trading account. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumb up and share it with fellow traders. Don't forget to subscribe for more valuable trading insights. Until next time, trade smart, trade with a plan, and trade to succeed.